So, Skippy. Skippy. You'd like to be our new counterman?
Yes.
And why is that?
I don't know.
Well, let's take a look at what kind of experience you've had. It says here you raked leaves for G. Stewart. Who is G. Stewart?
My grandpa.
Well, what does the G stand for?
Grandpa.
What's his real name?
Grandpa.
I see. Well, it says here you had a paper route.
It was really my sister's. But sometimes she let me put the rubber bands on plastic bags when it rained.
Uh-huh. And it also says here you made the most money in your eighth grade class for a cookie drive last year.
Yep, $1.40.
Skippy, is there anything you'd like to know about this job?
Well, is there a pension plan?
I don't know. I'll check for you, though. Well, thanks for coming in, and we'll put your applications with the others, and we'll let you know.
Okay.
Look, I gotta ask, how'd you get a name like Skippy?
I don't know. Forget our date this weekend, did you, Booch?
Well, are you kidding? I'm breathless with anticipation. Oh, chasmatize.
Booch, please tell me you are here for the job of counterperson.
Me? Stand behind a counter and sell cheeseburgers? Come on, think what that would do to my image. Think what it would do to my hair.
I'm sorry, I don't know what I was thinking.
Ben. Lana, what are you doing here?
I came back to see you.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. I thought you moved to Idaho.
I just couldn't stay away from you any longer.
Yeah, that's nice.
Don't you remember that last night we saw each other?
Lana, give me a break. It's been almost 2 years.
We went to the movies, and then we...
Well, yeah, well, I sold the trampoline. And, I'll see you around, all right?
See me around? Booch, I'm back.
Lana, I'm a busy man in the Lamar department these days.
Too busy for me? I mean, I thought we could pick up where we left off.
Listen, we had a great time, Lana, but it's over.
I see Lana's back. You two gonna start seeing each other again?
No way, she's a ditz.
Seems okay to me. There's nothing the matter with her.
Look out, Tom! Terri put a bomb in that cigar!
I feel it, Booch. I feel the wind in the air for Venice High. Must be the LA Times calling for a pregame interview. Hello. Oh, hello, Lana. Booch? No. Booch isn't here right now. He's, playing the piano. No, he's at his music lesson right now. It's somewhere over the rainbow. Oh, you left a gift for Booch on the porch? Okay, I'll bring it right in. All right, see you later.
Hey, remind me never to choose you for my charades team.
Uh,
Booch, it's a basket.
What?
A baby.
A baby? It is a baby. Booch, this is Anthony. I think you should get to know him. He's your son?
What?
No way.
Wait a minute, Booch.
And I forget it. This baby couldn't be mine.
We're talking biology, Booch. Are you saying you didn't...
Hey.
If you two had had a romantical tut-tut-tut, couldn't there have been a little accident?
No.
Well, it does look a little like you, Booch.
What? Got no hair, no teeth, no leather.
Hi, Chaz. Hi, Booch. What's that?
What do you think it is? It's a baby.
What's it doing here?
We found it on the doorstep. It's Booch's.
Wow, really? Gee, Booch, I didn't even know you were pregnant.
What's the matter with it?
Well, either he's hungry or his diaper needs to be changed.
How do you know so much about babies? You come from a big family?
No, I watch 30-something.
Is that a baby? What's going on?
It's Booch's.
What?
No way. Remember Crazy Lana from 2 years ago? Well, it's her baby. I'm gonna call her right now.
Oh, he's adorable. He reminds me of Chaz.
Ah, oh, come on. Chaz isn't bald, and he's a whole lot taller.
Except that Chaz had red hair and one little tooth in the front of his mouth, and he blew bubbles all the time. Oh. And he had a blue blanket just like this one. He wouldn't make a move without it. I think he was about 7 or 8 when he gave it up.
Wow.
You know, it took me the longest time to potty train him. He just didn't seem to mind walking around with a...
Mom!
Would you stop with the baby stories?
Did you find Lana?
Nah, I called the wrong number. Got a Thai restaurant.
Well, how about information?
No listing. I don't even know where to start looking for her.
Well, you can't keep the baby here.
What are we supposed to do with it?
Well, you can take it to the pound.
Eugene, you don't take a baby to the pound.
No, I guess you're right. All those dogs barking would probably keep it awake.
Wait a minute, I know. You know that woman, Ellen, oh, I can't think of her last name. She moved into old man Kegel's house. She's a social worker. She'll know exactly what to do in a situation like this. Oh, listen, guys, I'll be back 20 minutes tops, okay? Oh, and if anything goes wrong, just send,
I'll be right back.
Oh, it's almost time for the game, Mr. Russell.
All right. Listen, Booch, I guess you won't be able to make it.
Whoa, wait a minute.
Look, I'll run back right after the game. I'm sorry.
You like cycles, too? Hey, take a look. Motorcycles are very cool. Chicks love them. But you gotta wear a helmet. Don't forget that. Hey, you hungry? Yeah, why don't you finish the bottle Crazy Lana left you? There you go. Hey, there's some arm you got there, not too shabby. Hey. Yeah. Come on. Boy, You're just a little guy, aren't you? Hey, you want to hear a story?
All right.
How about Cinderella? Booch's version, right? Once upon a time, there was this really outrageous chick named Cinderella. Very foxy. Anyway, there was this party she wanted to check out, but his stepmom grounded her. Right? So the night of the party, while Cindy was throwing out the garbage, her fairy godmother turns an eggplant into this top-of-the-line Corvette with a cellular phone. And off she goes. Well, Cindy gets to the party, and the prince falls in love with her. Not Prince the rock star, but a real prince, you know, with a crown. But Cindy's gotta have the Corvette back by midnight, so she leaves one of her glass sneakies at the party. So the prince tracks her down. When the prince tracks her down, and when she tries on the sneaker, the Reebok, it fits. Yeah, they buy a condo in Marina Del Rey, and they live happily ever after. Hey, you like that, huh? Hey. What's this? Whoa. What's this? You lost your booty. Hey, that's not too cool. Hey, fortunately for you, no other babies went around to see it. Hey. Don't look at me like that. Come on, hey. Your mommy will be back for you. Come on. Please. You see, there's no way you can stay here, you know? You stay up late, play the stereo real loud. You know, grown-up stuff. You wouldn't like it here.
Hi, Booch. Good news.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Ellen says that she can place the baby in a foster home until Lana shows up.
Come on, sweetie.
There you go. What if she doesn't come back?
Well, then they're going to have to put him up for adoption.
Come on. Hey, Mrs. Russell. Nobody's taking Tony away from me. He's my son, and I'm going to raise him.
You can't keep this baby.
Why not? It's mine.
But I thought you said you weren't sure about that.
Yeah, well, now that we spent a little time together, I know little Tony better. He's definitely mine.
Hey, what's going on?
Butch wants to keep Tony. You can't take care of this baby. You don't know the first thing about it.
I'll learn. They got books about these things, you know?
When you're in school, who's going to take care of him?
I'll take Tony to one of those daycare places.
You're going
to
pay for that.
I'll get a job. Hey, you still looking for somebody down at Zorroberger?
Yeah, but
listen. If Lana says Tony's my kid, then I'm not going to try to get out of it. You can't just have a baby and give it away.
I understand that, Booch, but you don't understand.
No, don't worry. It's going to work out. You'll see.
I think you're making a mistake.
No. I'm fixing a mistake. What's the matter? You lose your rattle? Hey. There you go, big guy. Hey, that's a cool glove. Just like Daddy's. But you know, if you want to grow up to be big and strong, you gotta eat your formula. Yeah, that's right. You don't want any of those other babies laughing at your skinny bod down at the sandbox. Okay. Daddy's gotta get back to work now.
How's Tony?
Great, I think he likes it here.
Cool.
Whoa, what's the matter with you? Some people are trying to go sleepy by.
Hey,
Rock-a-bye, baby, on the treetop. When the wind blows, the cradle will rock. Buckle down, wind, socky, buckle down. You can win, win, socky, if you buckle down.
Boosh, 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 boosh. It's 6 o'clock in the morning. This is no time to be singing Buckle Down, Wind Socky.
Yeah, I know. Tony woke up. I think he had a bad dream. I think it was caused by that thing you're wearing on your face.
Well, I know how it feels. I had a bad dream, too. I dreamt I had an algebra final in third period today, and I didn't get any sleep before it. But guess what, Boots? It's not a dream!
Yeah, I can't help it if Tony can't sleep. I think he's got that thing that collies get.
That's colic, Boots! Colic!
Listen, Boots, Tony's a great kid, but the three of us living here, it just isn't gonna work out.
Yeah, I know. And maybe you should move back in with your mom.
But this was my apartment first!
Hey, I know. I'm sorry, Chaz. Hey, but Tony's my son.
But you're 17. You're too young to be a father.
Here's living proof that I'm not.
But you're still a kid yourself. I mean, don't you see that?
Yeah, I can't give him up, Chaz. I love Tony, and I'm not gonna let him down. Lana! Where the hell you been?
I'm just gonna go over to my mom's and, well, I was... Yeah.
Did you and Anthony get to know each other?
Hey, why don't you tell me about Tony when you first found out you were pregnant, huh? Why'd you wait all this time and then dump him on my doorstep?
I wanted it to be a surprise.
Okay, come on, cut that out. Listen, I've been doing some serious thinking.
Well, I should hope so now that you're a father and everything.
Yeah, well, listen. I got a job, and I think you and me should consider getting married.
Oh, Booch! I knew you loved me. I just knew it.
Hey. I'm doing this for the baby, and I want you to get the wrong idea.
We're gonna be so happy, Booch. You'll see. Everything's gonna be just perfect.
Booch, you gotta see what's on television.
Taken from his mother's station wagon last Saturday outside the Lilac Street Zorroberger. The 6-month-old toddler has a small birthmark on his wrist. Anyone knowing the whereabouts of little Jeffrey Banks is instructed to contact the local police. Enough.
Don't look at me that way. I did it for us, Booch. We can get married and keep the baby. Maybe even have one of our own. It'll be fine. You'll see. We'll be together forever now.
Operator, give me the police.
Car just pulled out. The baby's mother's here.
Can't believe it. Kidnapping.
Yeah, Lana's some wacko. Police say she's got 2 prior arrests in Nevada for impersonating a Viking.
Oh. Well, I said the Lana was crazy. I guess you were right.
I'm Marion Banks. Oh, Jeffrey. Oh,
my baby.
Oh, I can't thank you enough for what you've done. I guess there's just no way you can understand how I feel not being a parent yourself.
I think he's got the idea.
I hope he didn't give you any trouble.
Oh, no, he's a good kid.
Yeah. When I thought about the possibility of never seeing him again, I...
Yeah, it must have been rough.
All his toys and food are in this bag right here. Oh,
thank you. You've been very kind.
Listen, can I say goodbye then?
Oh, of course. Here, just put your hand under his head.
I know. Well, I guess it's goodbye. Sorry I called you Tony. But Jeffrey's a cool name. Hey, I don't want you spitting up on Mommy's blouse, right? But crying all through the night. And when you start school, I want you to pay attention, not goof off. One very important thing, never buy a cycle with over 5,000 miles on it.
Bye-bye.
You keep in touch, right? I love you.
Oh, what's the matter, Booch? You missed the baby already?
Yeah, a little bugger grows on you.
Well, we did make pretty good daddies, but let's face it, our bachelor days are far from over.
You got that right.
I mean, we're not ready to settle down yet.
Not even close. Hey, aren't we supposed to be telling everybody what's coming up next?
Oh, right. Stay tuned for an hour of Werewolf. You can catch Werewolf on Saturday nights, right after our show. And our show, of course, is...
Tootie, Woody, Woody, Woot.
Tootie, Woody, Woody, Woot, right here on Fox.
She's beautiful. She's a teacher. One of her students is trying to kill her. And when Johnny Depp falls in love with her, he becomes a marked man. 21 Jump Street, tomorrow. Then... Television's first weekly manhunt begins, where you, the viewer, can help the FBI locate their most sought-after criminals. America's Most Wanted, tomorrow.